Hey guys. Look, you know, one of the things I love about my job is I'm always learning and finding out about new equipment. And to my surprise today, my predecessor in this job had ordered some equipment and I got to play with this, a new 3D printer. So guys, this is the Flashforge Inventor 2. It's actually a really neat little printer. You can see definitely by the way it's actually laid out, is very similar to the MakerBot Mini, which is a really interesting printer in its own right. This thing is actually made out of plastic. It's a little plastic case from here and here. So if, as you can see, this printer actually has a top on it. With this one here, you actually see that it has some really, really neat little setup here. You've got twin rails, which is really helpful. And you can see here, this is very similar to the MakerBot system. It's all enclosed. You can't really get into the extruder, but it's all kind of really simple. The other thing that I like about this, taking a cue from MakerBot as well, is that you've got your material all internally placed in there. There's a little mini reel. Using this printer is really, really easy. There's a little button here that should turn on the power. You can see it lights up on the inside. And everything here has got some a digital screen. This again is really kind of intuitive. I like this a lot compared to the MakerBot. Apart from the actual design problems with the extruder, this machine seems to be really, really aimed at the beginners. There's Flashforge's little audio tone. Everything comes up. It's really, really simple to operate. I've been playing with this now for the last couple of hours. Let me see if I can get around here without the glare. And it's just simple as hitting the preheat button. It's, you've got your set for the extruder, and it's really intuitive. This is really aimed at the market for beginners, which is exactly what we want to do with the library here. The other thing that's really cool about this, and I'm actually going to abort this and go back, is actually in the tools, this level setup. This is something that I wouldn't have expected from Flashforge. It is building on a lot of the riprap technology, and if I hit the level here and open the door to show you guys what's going on, this will actually end up raising the table. Just place the camera down here. And you can see that it is raising the table to the extruder. What it actually asks you to do up here is to actually unwind the three nuts. So I'm gonna do that as well, and you can see here that these are actually the screw nuts, which is really easy to operate. You just wind them all the way back. This one as well. And there's a third one right at the back here. I don't know if you guys can see that. And then what actually happens is that it actually comes out with a little servo arm. So coming back to the screen here, we'll just tap the OK. It asks you if you can't tighten them anymore. I say yes. And then the actual head moves, and that little arm is a servo arm with a little switch at the bottom. And what you'll see is that they've already worked out exactly where the height's supposed to be for the extruder. We'll come up and measure. And it will actually come back up here and say, the distance is too big, so unscrew the corresponding nut, and it actually shows you how to do it. So let's do it. And then the idea is that we actually do it until there's a sound, there's a beep. Keep going. There's the beep. It'll say tap to verify. Let's tap that. There we go. It actually says to me here that I still have a little bit of a area to go. So let's do that again. Now that it's done it, it's going to check again. And it tells me the distance is still too big. So it'll keep asking me that. And one of the things that I found with this is because it is a physical switch, sometimes it's good to just give it a little bit more of a turn, just so that it'll actually click in. And once it's done that, it's still verifying it on the screen. Let's see what happens. There you go. It says congrats. Not congratulations, but congrats. Okay. Tap it. and you'll see it'll move to the next point. I really like how that little servo just flicks up and down. Still too distant, so it's really simple. The screen will actually show you here what to do, which is really nice. So you can't really do anything too wrong. I know that in my early days, I used to write notes to myself, which was, so what we're doing now is we're actually doing the last part. So I'm in here now. It's a three screw system. So I'm just on that center, just bringing it up. Come back up and verify. It does like to demand, doesn't it? Here we are. Yep, that's it. It's all complete. Now it's going to rest up. So that's actually the leveling system on this printer. It's very quick. It's about 5 minutes tops if you've got to go back and forth, but we are all verified and completed and ready to print. So the other thing that this printer actually has, which I really like, is it has an internal memory. So if we come up to the card here, you can actually see that if we go back to the main and we hit build, you actually have a USB stick, so you can actually take any standard USB stick. There's a slot on the side. Otherwise, you actually have an internal memory system in here. So you can actually upload through USB directly to the machine itself, which is what we're going to do with the library, which means that people can come and pick and print out whatever they need. So I've actually got a few things already loaded up here. It's calipers that I tried and a logo for the service up here. So we're going to go walk through right now, loading up a STL into the internal memory. We use a program called FlashPrint. So to actually use this piece of software, it's really simple. You just grab a USB and plug it into the side of the machine. And I'm going to do that now. So what we have here is we have my desktop, and I'm actually running FlashPrint. And all you need to do is I actually have what I was going to print out already organized, but basically it's the standard print software, so you can move it around, you can move your STL around as well, and as you go into different borders, you actually have the problem that you won't be able to print as those areas come up. I'm actually going to use the default and center that on the actual grid. You can rotate it, you can scale it up and down, and you can also cut, which is really nice on this. So if you've got something that's really big, you can actually take a slice and be able to separate a larger STL into two different areas, which I really like. Then simply, again, based off the regular software that I've had experience with, you hit print, you enable or disable the supports. We're not using supports right now. I'm also turning the raft off, and all you need to do is hit okay, and now that will actually save, and also send it to the printer itself when you hit print. So it asks you the connect mode. Some models actually have Wi-Fi, but we're going to use USB. We connect with it. It is now running it straight to the machine. That is now in the memory of the machine. If we come up here and actually abort that print, but go back to internal memory, there's my logo right there. So I'm going to hit that. It comes to the screen. You can see a little display there of around about what that STL looks like. It's simply build, and then it tells you 49 minutes and also the extruder temperature. So again, you can see very, very easy. And this machine sits nicely on a desk. Let's see if I pull away here. It's not so big. There's my Apple Air next to it. So this is something that could actually sit on a table quite easily. And let's take a look at that. This door actually has a magnet in it, so with it's open, it'll actually see here. It'll say the door is open, please close the door. If I hit OK, it'll go back, and it actually stopped. That's really neat. Close it. I haven't tried that before. Okay, it stopped not because of the door, but it stopped because the extruder still isn't up to temperature. Really neat. A really nice little machine. I'm going to keep the door open so we can actually kind of look inside. Door open. And again, we're almost there at temperature. I like this machine, you know? It's small, it's for someone who's beginning to get into 3D printing. Especially with the hood that goes on top. It's actually very quiet. That's the other thing that I really am impressed with this machine. As opposed to the MakerBot Mini. The MakerBot Mini sides are just one big kind of acoustic drum. You can really hear what's going on. And if you can see here, as it's laying down some material, it is quiet as anything. And I've actually been running this machine all day next to my workstation, and it hasn't bothered me once. It is a very neat little machine. So let me take some footage from up top. Can't really see too much because of the automatic system. You can see there's just really a box with the extruder and the arm within it. But again, it's a nice little piece of equipment. Let me know what you think. I actually am quite impressed with this machine. This machine is going to go into the Hobsons Bay Library, and I'm going to set it up so that the librarians can use it easily, and the public will be able to get a chance to use it as well. So let me know what you think. This is the Flashforge Inventor 2. This machine turned up today, and I have been playing with it, and I thought I'd just take the opportunity to share it with you guys. I will show you the logo at the end, but I'm not going to sit through 49 minutes of this popping out. Okay, talk soon. So that's the print done. You can actually see it here. This is my logo. It's actually the first time I've printed this before. I actually really like how it came out. I really like this machine. If you're interested in getting into 3D printing and definitely want to do some work without the technical aspects, you don't want to have a kit, you don't want to have to put something together and tweak it all the time, I think this printer is definitely a good choice. I'm really excited about seeing this printer be put out in the public and letting people play with it. This printer is available from Flashforge. I believe it's just around the $1,000 mark. As I come across new equipment, I'm going to share it with you guys. So, I'll speak to you real soon. Thanks so much.